وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى I'm going to go into the second introduction بإذن الله الكريم before I go into the topic which is الحق the truth يجب أن يقبل ممن قاله the truth must be accepted from whoever says it سواء كان من الموافقين أو المخالفين سواء كان من الموافقين أو المخالفين the truth is accepted from whoever says it whether this person is your friend he's with you he's your ally or whether he's your opponent or whether he is your enemy doesn't matter The truth is taken from anybody who says it. ولذلك, there is a famous saying which is الحكمة ضالة المؤمن متى ما وجدها أخذها. That wisdom is a lost property of the believer. Wherever he finds it, he takes it. So a person should really give consideration to people who critique you. Don't ignore it because they are not your friends or they are ally, they are your enemies and they are your opponents. And don't try to use as an excuse that these people have an ulterior motive, they are jealous. And don't try to use an argument as to say they're still immature, they're going to grow. The truth is accepted from anybody, whether they are young or whether they are old, whether they're your friend or whether you're a staunch enemy. It doesn't matter. It is taken on board. It's accepted. And we're not, and we shouldn't, sorry, we shouldn't be ones who dismiss it and ignore it because if we look at the person, we look at the person and we say, I don't like him. No. بَلْ يَتَأَمَّلُ فِيهِ The true believer who's seeking Allah's face, he looks at the person's criticism. وَيُرَاجِعُ نَفْسَهُ He goes back to himself and he asks himself a couple of questions. Reason is because the people who are against you or the people that don't like you, if you think this person doesn't, generally they're the people who can really see your mistakes. The ones around you, they don't see that. They just, mashallah, Allahumma barik, mashallah, Allahumma barik. The true people who see your criticism or see your faults and your mistakes are your enemies. They look at it, they see it, they see things that your friends and your allies might not even be looking at. And they bring it to your attention. And that's why some of the scholars, they say, وَعَيْنُ النَّاقِدِ عَادَةً بَصِيرَةٌ بِعُيُوبِ الْمَنْقُودِ That the one who's refuting you, the one who's debunking your arguments, the one that is dispelling your misconceptions, he can see deeply into your faults that maybe other people can't. So يجب أن يقبل إن كان حقا. If what he's saying is the truth, you should accept it. ويرد إن كان باطلا. If what he's saying is false, then just don't accept it, reject it. Because it's false, not because he said it. Don't look at the methodology of the person who's opposing you. Oh, what's his methodology? Oh, I'm not going to accept it. What's his ideology? Nah, I'm not going to accept it. What's his situation like? Ah, he doesn't even pray the salah. Ah, I'm not going to accept it from him. All of that is irrelevant. You don't look at his manhaj. You don't look at his situation. You don't even look at his credentials. Nope, he said the truth. He spoke the truth. You know it's the truth. You accept it from him. And I'll give you an example on that. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he affirmed for the Jews, something that he said about the Muslims. Yani the Jews, something that they said about the Muslims. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, نِعْمَ الْقَوْمُ The Jews, they said to the believers, the Yahud said to the believers, نِعْمَ الْقَوْمُ أَنْتُمْ لَوْلَا أَنَّكُمْ تُشْرِكُونَ You guys are the best of people if only you didn't do shirk. The Jews are saying this to the believers. They're saying this to the Sahabas. You guys would be the best of people if you didn't do shirk. تَقُولُونَ You guys say, مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ وَشَاءَ مُحَمَّدُ You say, if Allah wills and Muhammad wills. So you connect the mashi'a of Allah with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You connect the will of Allah with the will of the Prophet. You do shirk. Then the issue was brought to the Prophet's attention. The messenger said, أَمَا وَاللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُ لَأَعْرِفُهَا لَكُمْ قُولُوا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ شَاءَ مُحَمَّدٌ The Prophet said, I knew this for you guys. And what they said is right. They spoke the truth. From this minute onwards, the Prophet said to the companions, قُولُوا Say, مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ شَاءَ مُحَمَّدٌ Say if Allah wills and then if Muhammad wills. Ibn Majah narrated this and hadith is sahih. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam affirmed alayhi salatu wasalam ala ma abu bihi ba'd al-muslimin fi tilka al-maqula. The criticism that the Jews brought against the Muslim, the noble companions, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam affirmed it. Ma'a kawnihim yahudi. Ma'a kawnihim yahudan. Even though these people are what? They're Jews. غَيْرُ طَالِبِينَ لِلْحَقِّ فِي نَقْدِيمِ They're not sincere in their criticism. They have no intention of accepting the truth. وَإِنَّمَا قَصَدُوا عَيْبَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ Their intent was to fault the Muslims. That's all they wanted. The Prophet didn't look at their situation. He didn't look at their motive. He didn't look at their credentials. No. He took it because it's the truth. صلى الله عليه وسلم. So I say, to all of you who are watching, there are many reasons why people reject the sincere advice that's put to them. They reject it. And they reject it in many different ways. The reason why they reject it, I'm going to come to that. But they use many different tactics to reject the advice that's put to them. Sometimes they put it as, oh, I grew out of refuting others and debunking others. I kind of grew out of that. It's them saying, I'm beyond and above criticism. That's the truth. They come about it sometimes in that way. Sometimes they come about it by saying, inshallah, they'll grow out of it. They'll, inshallah ta'ala, understand that this is not the way forward. That's a method they use. Another method that they may go about it is by saying, don't try to build your legacy on trying to refute others. Don't build your legacy on refuting others. That's what they'll say. These are the qawalib, the forms in which they use to reject the sincere advice that's put to them. But what is their reason why they don't want to accept it? What is their, I've told you the ways that they do it, or some of the ways they do it. But what is their reason? Why don't they want to accept it? The reason is because عَدَمُ الْتِفَاتِهِمْ لِنَقْدِ النَّاقِدِينَ They don't look at the person's criticism and what he put because he's their opponent. They looked at the person first before they looked at the criticism. They don't like this person. He's of a particular group or he's a particular ethnicity or a particular language. Forget it. Or even from a particular land. So then he's my opponent. Why am I going to accept it from him? هو من خصومي. He's my opponent. Why am I going to accept him from my opponent? Or هو من أقران. He's my contemporary. He and I used to be in the same class. How am I going to accept his advice? It happens sometimes. And sometimes it's shaytan is working in this person. He wants to use this person. أَن يَصُدَّ الْعَبْدَ بِهَا عَنِ الْإِنْتِفَاعِ بِالنَّصِيحَةِ What does it want? It wants to take this person from benefiting from the sincere advice. Just take it. It's for you. It's your benefit. But shaytan is working in this person, preventing this person from benefiting from the sincere advice. It's shaytan that's controlling them and they don't really understand. And sometimes it's because of arrogance. They are من المتكبرين المصرين على أخطائهم. They are from the arrogant people. They want to be persistent upon their wrongdoings. غير معترفين بتقصيرهم أو مخالفتهم للحق. They do not want to accept. They do not want to affirm that they fell short. They're wrong. They can't. It's too hard. So what do you find them? فتجدون يحاولون صرف الناس عن نقد الناقدين لهم ونصح الناصحين. So you find them. They divert the people from that person. They divert the people from that person. They put a name to that people. Yeah, that's what they are. These people are known. معروفين. Okay, that's what they say. They attach a name to the person. And he doesn't look at the advice or the criticism. constructive criticism. He doesn't look at it. He looked at the person first. Don't accept it. Sometimes what he does is that he attacks the person without looking at the criticism and the justness of what was said. He doesn't. So they start insulting the person. وَطَعْنِ فِي عَقِيدَتِهِمْ وَأَوْمَنْهَجِهِمْ. They start to slander the person's aqeedah or manhaj. وَطَعْنِ فِي نِيَاتِهِمْ. Sometimes they even question your intentions. وَمَقَاصِدِهِمْ. Ah, you want to be famous. That's why you're doing all of this. Ah, fame is what you're looking for. يَصْرِفُونَ النَّاسَ عَنْ عُيُوبِهِمْ وَتَقْصِيرِهِمْ الَّذِي كُشِفَ وَعُرِّيَ بِنَقْدِ النَّاقِدِينَ. And they divert the people from their faults and their errors and their mistakes and their shortcomings. They divert the people from it and they just point the blame at that people. And this, brothers, is common on many, many, many people. May Allah protect us from it. A group of people might think it's only to a particular people. No, a lot of people fall into this. Ah, there's a lot of people that don't want to accept the truth when it comes to them. They don't surrender when the truth comes to them. Not like the ones Allah said, إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. That's the true believer. He hears and he obeys straight away. He doesn't argue. He doesn't throw justifications. Straight away he says, did Allah and His Messenger say this? Ha, I take it. Brothers and sisters, if anybody criticizes you, if anybody brings your fault or your mistakes to you, thank the person. Thank that individual who criticized you, that person who advised you. Just accept it and thank them. Especially if the person he took سَلَكَ سَبِيلَ الْعِلْمِ وَالْأَدَبِ. Especially if that person critiqued you with knowledge. So it's a constructive criticism. And they also used manners and etiquettes. They didn't personally attack you. They didn't put you down. They genuinely brought the advice to you in a very well-mannered, accepted. And if they do not take a mannered method, if they do not take it with adab, accept it because it's your lost property. Just accept it. If you want to thank them for it, that's another thing. But accept the truth regardless of how it's been told to you. Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. At this time that we live, Muhammad Abdul Wahhab is one of the most attacked Muslim scholar of our time. Alisa Kadalik, is that not the case? He is. Look what he said to his opponents who attacked him, who fought with him, physically fought with him. And many things have been said about him. Look how his personality was. Rahimahullah. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, look what he said. He said, وَأَنَا أُشْهِدُ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ وَأُشْهِدُكُمْ عَلَى دِينِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ أَنِّي مُتَّبِعُ لِأَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ وَمَا غَابَ عَنِّي مِنَ الْحَقِّ وَأَخْطَأْتُ فِيهِ فَبَيِّنُوا لِي وَأَنَا أُشْهِدُ اللَّهَ أَنِّي أَقْبَلُ عَلَى الرَّأْسِ وَالْعَيْنِ وَالرُّجُوعِ إِلَى الْحَقِّ خَيْرٌ مِنَ التَّمَادِي فِي الْبَاطِلِ. He said, I bear witness to Allah and the angels, and I bear witness, and I order you all to witness in the religion and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَنِّي مُتَّبِعُ لِأَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ, that I follow Allah and His Messenger. I follow the scholars of Al-Islam. وَمَا غَابَ عَنِّي مِنَ الْحَقِّ, anything that is hidden from me from the truth. And he's not an infallible person. He's saying that. If anything is hidden from me that I didn't see from the religion, or I did a mistake, وَأَخْطَأْتُ فِيهِ, and I made a mistake, فَبَيِّنُوا لِي, clarify to me. Show me my mistakes. وَأَنَا أُشْهِدُ اللَّهِ, and I bear witness. أَنِّي أَقْبَلُ عَلَى الرَّأْسِ وَالْعَيْنِ, I will accept it from you guys. It's on my head. Bring it to me. Something that I said was wrong, or I did a mistake, show it to me. I promise you I will leave it. I will repent. I'll come back. وَالرُّجُوعُ إِلَى الْحَقِّ خَيْرٌ مِنَ التَّمَادِي فِي الْبَاطِلِ. وَالرُّجُوعُ, coming back to the truth, خَيْرٌ مِنَ التَّمَادِي فِي الْبَاطِلِ, is better than dwelling into the falsehood. So inshallah ta'ala, whatever advices I give, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ, in this series, accept it if it's the truth. And anything I might have said that was wrong, فَاضْرِبُوهُ عُرْضَ الْحَائِضِ, smack it against the wall and reject it. Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to stop there, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ وَبِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel. Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.